Sorry about that, guys. Had a couple of technical difficulties there. All right. We are going to get right into this. Sorry about that. We had some audio issues there while we were getting started. This morning, we're going to jump right in. Since we had those tech issues, I want to be conscious of your time this morning and respectful. So we basically wanted to put this together for you guys because we've had a ton of questions. As you may have seen in the intro video, you know, we've talked with almost 200 agents in the last probably 60 days. As we get near the end here of the year, kind of in the back nine, as I like to call it, of the year, we have just a lot of agents who are kind of looking to reevaluate their marketing. We've seen a surge of folks coming through, primarily in the captive world with Allstate, State Farm, Farmers, all over the country, with looking for a good solid lead provider. And we've had a lot of questions about how we do things, what really makes us different, because there's tons of lead providers out there. There's a bunch of marketing gurus and, you know, online Facebook lead generation experts. And we get asked the question, you know, what makes you guys different? How are you, you know, what are you guys doing other, you know, from these other guys? I've tried this or I've tried that and it's really not working. So I really just kind of wanted to put things into perspective, kind of show you what we're doing, how we're generating leads. I think when we closed out July, we looked at just over 6,000 leads that we generated for our clients in the month of July alone. And you know, we've got one of the highest retention rates in the industry for our lead providers, folks looking to continue to work with us, continue to grow. And I think we've got just a few things here to share with you that will kind of open your eyes and help you see what we're doing that's different, help you understand our methodology and some of the strategies that we use. So I'm gonna first talk with you about the Facebook platform. Although we are a true digital marketing agency where we work on platforms such as Google, LinkedIn, and Facebook, as well as retargeting. We do marketing automation. We have some automation and live transfer, click-to-call campaigns that we do, automated booked appointments, and a host of other services. But primarily want to talk with you about the inbound Facebook lead generation and show you why this platform is so powerful and why our strategy works so well for the agents who are working with us. So with that, I will jump right in here. And get started. Okay, so there's a huge opportunity right now for insurance agents on the Facebook platform, primarily because it's an underutilized platform, first and foremost. Social media is obviously relatively new. Facebook, although it's the largest, it is the most effective, and I think provides the biggest opportunity for insurance agents. And I wanna show you some data as to why that is. If you look at 68% of U.S. adults use Facebook, 51% of them log in several times a day. And although you may not log in daily, you know, this really helps you to see just how many people that are out there are using Facebook. And it's just gives us an opportunity to really market to those folks multiple times a day on a platform that they use more often than any other platform. It's more effective than print, it's more effective than radio, more effective than television, more effective than direct mail, primarily because frequency is the name of the game when you look at any advertising strategy. You know, the number of times that you hit somebody, there's a direct correlation to the number of conversions. So the average number of friends that any user has is about 338. And this number becomes very important when you look at how the Facebook algorithm works and understanding that each person that you're connected with is connected to 300 more, which gives you an enormous opportunity to explode your brand very quickly and get seen by tens of thousands of people in just a short period of time. The average Facebook user that's 25 to 44 spends between 2 and 2.5 hours every day on Facebook, which leaves advertisers like yourself an extremely engaged audience that you can hit every single day. There's over 60 million active business pages, but only 6 million of those are actually active advertisers. So there's a difference between an active business page and an active advertiser. There's only 6 million business pages globally that are considered active advertisers, guys. That's a really, really small number of people. Although 6 million sounds huge, that's a global number. Put that in perspective, there's a million licensed insurance agents in the United States alone. So you can see that when you kind of dwindle that down to see how many active insurance companies are actually using Facebook to generate leads, it's a very, very small number. So it gives us an enormous opportunity here to hit the right person at the right time, right? And that's really what Facebook does. It delivers the right ad to the right person at the right time. I want to show you and help you understand how Facebook does what it does. A lot of people say, well, how do you get my ad in front of people? You know, what do people see, or you know, how does it work? So without spending a ton of time diving deep into the algorithm, just want to hit some high points and help you understand that Facebook has over 5,000 data points on over 200 million Americans. They know every like, every comment, every post that you've made, every direct message that you've sent, every website that you visit, every comment that you've made in every group. Depending on whether or not you have the app installed on your phone, they even have logs of your phone calls and text messages. They know when your birthday is, your anniversary, your relationship status. They know your job status. They know shopping habits, apps that you have on your phone, and on and on and on. But that also means they have this same information, not just about you, but about your friends and who they're connected to and everybody else that you're trying to reach. So, you know, it really allows us a place to put a targeted ad in front of the exact type of customer that you know that your underwriters are looking for. So it goes beyond just age and geographic targeting. We're able to look at things like education, the types of jobs that they hold, relationship status, and life events, right? So what I like to tell folks is think direct mail on steroids. It's direct mail gone digital on steroids. All right. So think if you sent out 10,000 mailers, but instead of just knowing who you're sending it to and their address, you also knew things like whether or not that person had just gotten divorced or is engaged and getting married or having kids or how many kids they have. You knew what types of jobs they hold. You know what their job titles are. You know their income status. If you knew all of that information, I think the piece of direct mail that you would send would be very different than maybe the generic piece that you might send. So that allows us to be very specific with our ad copy, understanding exactly where these people are, not geographically, but where they are in their life, in order to put the right ad in front of them at exactly the right time. And the great thing is that, you know, our customers who work with us, they don't have to understand how to do this. It's a good idea to understand how it works, but our team of experts does all of this legwork for you. We understand this algorithm, this platform, and how to use it. And we use all of these indicators and all of these filters to make sure that we're getting in front of the right person at the right time. My business partner, Doug, has a long history with State Farm. As a sales manager with a very large agency out in Arizona. I was also a team member and an agent aspirant at State Farm, and then I went and started my own book at Liberty Mutual. So we're very familiar with the captive world, and we understand the compliance issues that captive agents are facing, and it's the same ones that we faced, and we both use these strategies in our agency. Now, I think one of the key things to keep in mind is that we are full-time digital marketing agencies. We don't run an insurance agency and kind of dabble in this part-time. Our entire team is full-time. We don't have any, you know, this isn't something we're doing as a hobby. This is our business. This is what we do. A lot of quote-unquote Facebook marketers or, you know, other, you know, digital marketing guys that generate Facebook leads. Number one, most of these guys came through our programs and learned how to do this by working with us. And a lot of them are active insurance agency owners. So the last thing you want is somebody who has a business full time and is trying to manage their own agency and their own business, dabbling and half-ass running your leads. It's just not going to get you the best results possible. So one of the biggest things that we utilize and that I think it makes Facebook so important and so powerful is this retargeting. What this does is it tracks visitors who have clicked on ads, filled out forms, that follow insurance pages, have apps on their phones, have been to your website or been to other insurance websites. If you think of a time that maybe you went on to look at Priceline and you checked out Vegas hotels, and then you got on Facebook and all of a sudden you started seeing a bunch of Vegas hotel ads, right? That's retargeting. That's kind of the best way that I can help you describe and understand what retargeting is. And this is something that we use day in and day out for our customers to help get the exact type of person who is not only interested, but is also, following insurance pages and making comments and talking about getting insurance quotes, but they haven't yet gone shopping. So the key for us is, and the key strategy that we try to do is find the right type of individual that you're looking for who is also interested, but hasn't yet started shopping, right? Because by the time they get to Google, they've already started shopping. We're gonna talk to you a little bit about the difference between search-based marketing and disruptive marketing. And this is primarily disruptive marketing when we're using Facebook. But I wanna show you another live example. This just happened the other day, actually yesterday. So I made a comment about whether people follow Eric Thomas or Grant Cardone and which content they like better, right? And this happened inside of a group, right? And then what happened was this guy said, I like Jordan Belfort's podcast. And I liked this comment. You can see I liked it. So I liked this comment. And what happened was when I went in the newsfeed, the very next ad that I saw was from Jordan Belfort. We know this is an ad because it says sponsored, right? So this is exactly what like Facebook understands how to do. It goes so far beyond somebody who is maybe asking for a recommendation for insurance on their page. Although if they do that, they're going to get picked up in this retargeting strategy. But if they simply like a comment about somebody talking about insurance, they can get picked up in this audience that we're targeting. So, it goes, and we've got tons and tons of examples, but this is just kind of a quick snapshot to show you how this happens. Facebook just uses so much data and they have so much information about their users that you can rest assured they're getting these ads in front of the right people. And the great thing about getting ads in front of people before they go shopping is that it leaves it with just you and their current carrier. So it gives you a much higher contact rate and a much higher conversion rate. What we're finding is that the leads that are filling out our forms have been with their current insurance provider for, on average 5 to 9 years, which means they've been through a slew of rate increases, and it's going to make you look that much more competitive when you get in front of these guys. And they're also not shoppers, and they're retaining much longer than your traditional insurance lead. So here's an example. If you want to go look, you can access your own information and you can see exactly what Facebook knows about you. You go into your settings and you can simply look up and download all of your information, and they'll have everything. They'll show you everything that they have on you, and understand when you look at the enormous amount of information that they have about you, you can see, okay, this is what they're going to have in front of my customers. So it goes beyond just reaching people you're connected to, beyond people who are just connected to your page or who like your page. We're able to get in front of anybody in your state that you're looking to target. So here's another figure and I'm going to send you guys a copy of this presentation so that you'll have it. But this shows us the percentage of usage by platform and by age range. All right. And what I want to point out are a couple of key points here. When you look at some of these 50 and older demographics, so the baby boomers are the fastest growing demographic on Facebook right now. Assuming that 80% of all demographics will become active monthly users on Facebook, which I believe is going to happen if we look on some of these others, that's where they're at in these other age groups. And I believe that we're gonna see 80% usage across all age demographics, right? That's just the trend that the data is showing us. That means we still got 15% between 50 and 64 and 39% that are 64 and older who aren't even active monthly users. They're not even logging in monthly, all right? So we're gonna continue to see more and more users log on to Facebook. And like I said, it's the fastest growing demographic of new profiles being created on Facebook right now, right? And that's where people have the most money, right? That's where we're gonna get the larger households, and we're gonna get more premium, we're gonna get the risk adverse, we're gonna get just the better risk overall. But the key points to really look at is that 80% of people between 18 and 49 are using Facebook, only 65% between 50 and 64, and 41% between ages 64 and up. Although users 18 to 24 are on Facebook, it's not their primary platform. And to those that are 18 to 24, Facebook is old news. These guys have all but deserted the platform, and they're really focused on platforms like Instagram and Snapchat. And the reason I point that out is because this age bracket is really what determines where the next big thing is. So we pay close attention to what these folks are doing, as well as the 13 to 17 demographic. That really shows us where social media is heading. And so we can stay in front of the curve, and we're not being reactive, but instead we're proactive with our marketing strategy. But we typically focus on ages 25 and older with our marketing and the leads that we generate. Most agents tend to want people who are older than 25. They've got careers, they've got kids, they've got houses. So we're not generating, you know, a 19 or 21 year old college student monoline single car auto lead here. And we're gonna show you some lead examples here at the end of what they look like. But what you need to understand is how to interpret the data. We're finding that we get most of our traffic and we have a very high volume of leads and conversions between ages 25 and 49. This is where we get most of our volume. But although our volume isn't as high at 50 and older, we're excited about this demographic because we're getting much higher conversion rates as a percentage. And our lead costs at those that are ages 50 and up are actually 40% lower than ages 25 to 49. So we're getting a much higher conversion and a lower cost per lead. So we really like this demographic. And like I said, this is where the trend is growing for Facebook in particular. This is the age demographic that's really growing. And that's where we're focusing on making sure we're staying and retaining those. Although we have a higher volume here, I think there's gonna be a shift moving towards LinkedIn, Instagram, and Snapchat in the years to come. But there's still an enormous growth opportunity for those in the older demographics. And anytime there's a new advertising method for consumers, you see a very high percentage of conversion. And as users 50 and older give in and create their profile, all of these Facebook ads that they see are going to be really new. They're going to be surprised at, oh, how did they know I needed insurance? Or I just looked at, just talked to my wife about getting insurance quotes and here's this ad. How does that work? And so that whole newness factor hits with that demographic. But I talked here about the understanding the difference between search and disruptive. So Facebook is a disruptive advertising platform, whereas Google is a search-based platform. All right, here's some key figures to look at. Cost per CPM is a cost per thousand. This is really how Facebook prices their ads and how Google prices their ads. So, you know, when we talk about having an average cost per lead between $3 and $4 or $3 and $5 in a market, that's just the easiest way to help you understand what kind of results you're going to get out of any given marketing budget. But that's not really how they price it. They price it by the number of cost per thousand impressions. So on Facebook, you're averaging $11.20 per thousand impressions, which is the number of ad times your ad is seen. And you can see Google's cost per impression is actually $2.80. But what you can see is a much higher conversion rate of 2.36 click-through rate versus a 0.35. And that's primarily because there's not as much competition on Facebook as there is Google. So you're getting a much higher conversion rate. So although your impressions cost more, more of those impressions are converting into leads versus Google, where you have to pay a much higher volume, higher cost per click. You can see the cost per click is almost twice as high on Google. But what happens is when somebody goes to Google, they type in compare auto insurance quotes in Dallas, Texas. Right. And then all of these ads will pop up. And this is where most of your lead providers are playing. They're looking for people who are shopping for auto insurance. Right. Whereas Facebook, they don't go to Facebook and open up their Facebook newsfeed to go and search for auto insurance. But they do go there to interact with friends. And because Facebook has so much data, we know that exactly who this person is. We know that we want, say, a 35-year-old with a college degree, who is married and maybe has two kids and say works as an engineer or an architect, right, in this industry, because that person is going to probably have a good paying job. They're probably going to own a home. They're going to have better credit, be risk adverse, just a better risk, right? We don't know all of that on Google. All we know on Google is that they typed in these certain keywords or these key phrases. So we've got much higher insight here on Facebook. And then what Facebook does is it puts them in front of people based on those actions like I showed you earlier. So if I fit that demographic and I recently made a comment or talked about insurance or went to an insurance website, Facebook's gonna put that in my newsfeed. Not because I necessarily asked them to, but because they have enough data to know that, hey, there's a very high probability this guy's gonna be interested and respond favorably to an insurance ad, right? So they actually do all of the work with their algorithm and being able to put that in front of the right person. All you got to do is be able to understand how to target them and how to write good ad copy, and their algorithm puts it in front of those folks for you. So it's a very different, there's not a right or wrong way, it's just two very different ways. And what we're finding is that because it's not as crowded here on Facebook, we're getting much better results and our ad dollars are going much farther. So, you know, we've got an arsenal of resources that include over 250 different ad campaigns that cover every line of insurance. We also give you 4-day sales process, email scripts, phone scripts, text scripts, everything that you need. You know, we've worked with over 1500 agents and we know exactly what is working and how to engage these leads, how to convert them quickest. We've got an enormous amount of data to, you know, help you understand exactly what you're going to get out of every marketing dollar spent. Everything that we do is completely transparent. You see every campaign that we run. One of the things that we find with agents is, you know, they don't know where their leads are coming from. They don't know what the consumer is seeing before they respond to an ad. Most ads are not, or most leads obviously aren't exclusive, and they're certainly not delivered in real time. So you're really kind of shooting in the dark. Whereas working with us, you'll know exactly what campaign any ad or any lead saw. You'll know what your ads running look like. You'll know what they saw, so you'll be able to approach them accordingly. And you'll also know where every ad dollar is spent. You'll know what your cost per lead is on every lead, and you'll be able to make really good decisions. And everything that we do is really data driven. But some of the lead types that we can generate is auto, home, renters, life, universal, whole, mortgage protection, final expense, financial services, health, disability, long-term care, mortgage, home buyer, car buyer, refinance, even sellers if you work with real estate agents and you want to find some listing leads for those guys. But you know, our perfect customer targeting approach and our proprietary analytics calculator, which I'm going to show you here in just a second, helps you forecast the performance of every ad. You'll know exactly how much your ad is going to cost to continue to run, how many leads you're actually going to get out of that ad campaign. So you'll be able to help determine how much you should be spending each day on any given ad. So we generate all the reports and then we meet with you once a week to go over all of the performance metrics and then get the feedback from you in terms of how well you're converting, how many people have you quoted, how much have you sold, what went well, what didn't go well. And we, you know, get specific in terms of, hey, number lead 36, how did that go? Okay, perfect. It was, you know, a good lead. Why was it good? What happened? If it was a bad lead, why was it a bad lead? You know, we can start to see patterns of consistencies with good leads. We'll see that, hey, between this age bracket, this gender demographic, these targeting metrics seem to do really well with this office, and they tend not to do so well in these areas with these types of ads or this type of targeting. So each week we refine the campaigns based on the feedback that you give us, and we're able to get better and better quality leads. And typically over the course of 90 days, we actually, you know, we'll start at, you know, probably a $5 to $6 lead. And we end up, as we make the adjustments, we can end up lowering the cost by as much as 30 or 40% while your conversion rates increase to, you know, 10 to 15% in that 90 days. And so our average agent is reporting between 18 and 21% conversion on that initial contact versus a 3 to 8% on your traditional internet leads. In addition, clients are also reporting 65 to 75% contact rates on these leads in terms of getting appointments, making contact versus just calling and getting you know, bad contact information, not getting a hold of people, chasing them around, and then using our follow-up process, X-dating and, you know, working additional conversion strategies, increasing up to about 30% conversion over the course of 90 days. And again, we have a full marketing automation and email drip and lead nurture campaign that we build out and we can provide for agents as well. But ultimately what this means is you're gonna end up with higher quality leads, your ad budget goes farther. We typically take an agent on traditional internet leads. If they're spending $2,000, we can essentially get them the same results that they're getting with those 2,000, if not better, for a fraction, maybe 25 to 50% of that same ad budget. So you're having to work less leads because you're having more contacts. You know, if somebody's used to working five, you know, they get 10 leads a day because they want to have two quotes a day, you would only need maybe five leads a day from us to have those same two quoting opportunities. So you're working much better prospects who are actually looking forward to your call. A lot of times they'll actually call in to you directly or book their own appointment to have you call them back at a specific time, so you're not chasing them around. You're dealing with value-driven conversations versus just price shoppers. Because again, we're hitting them because Facebook understands this is a person who has a high probability to convert, not necessarily because they're out shopping for the cheapest price right now. So it leaves you to have much better conversations. You're closing more leads than traditionals, typically 4 to 5 times higher closing rates, and utilizing our marketing automation over the course of 90 days, you'll see as high as 30% conversion. On average, clients are reporting anywhere between 200 and 1,000% return on investment. It's 10 to 1 on the ad dollar spent versus the return that you're given. So some of the reports that we generate, what you can see is we call it our formula worksheet, but it shows you our conversion metrics, you know, how many clicks, how many leads, how many sales. Obviously, this was reported from the customer, how many sales and what the commission was. But you can see in this instance, the return on investment's at 398%. But we can also see that he's got another 12 leads left in this campaign. We've got how many people have seen the ad, what the total audience size is, and what the total reach is. So we've got another 297 people out of this 1,500 that we're going to reach. We're going to get 12 of these 297 to convert. And based on his conversion rate, we should probably end up somewhere around $1,200 to $1,300 on a $300 ad spend. But what we also look at is our age and gender demographics, where we're getting the best results, age ranges, gender ranges, how many have converted, how many forms and quotes were requested in each of these brackets. And what we're able to do is refine these down. And so when you tell us a lead converted, we're going to look at all this data and figure out, okay, which ad did it come from? Number one, how old is this individual? Is it male or female? And we can start to put together a really definitive customer profile of where you're getting the best results. So as we launch new ads, we can really go ahead and trim the fat. So if we know that all of your conversions happen between 35 and 54, then over time, we're just going to eliminate these other age brackets, which is going to save us money. It might compromise the quantity, but most agents are more worried about quality. And we can really refine that process by looking at some of these metrics and the feedback that you give us. So we've got a very successful strategy and a long track record of success. It's very much a multifaceted approach. It's highly customized, and it's really like you guys are like having your own marketing agency working for you. You're very much involved in the process. You get to really see everything as it unfolds. We're going to help you understand, teach you what we're doing, help you understand the decisions that we're making, why we're making those decisions. Everything is data driven. We don't make any guesses. So we really let the data drive us. This is not purchasing leads. We're a digital marketing agency. So you know, our specialty is inbound lead generation and really taking that feedback from you and building a campaign based on what the data is telling us and what you're telling us is working well for you. So each week we make adjustments, we get better and better results. And it's very rare that we get to the end of a month with a client and they say, well, that didn't work, right? Because we stay in front of it by having these weekly meetings with our customers. We do in-depth customer research in terms of demographic insight, data analysis, affinity marketing, strategic partnerships, customer solution-driven campaigns that really get you solutions-driven prospects versus just price shoppers like you get from Google. So you may have used Facebook ads in the past. You may have worked with somebody who did Facebook marketing and it didn't work for you. And I just want to kind of show you why that might have been. So if you look at the industry average in 2018 of what the average click-through rate is, average conversion rate, and the average cost per click, this is all Facebook data. The average cost per click is $3.77 with a click-through rate of 0.0056. Now, if you just look here, this is the click-through rate of this campaign, 8.79% versus 0.0056. The reason this happens is because of the targeting, the remarketing that we do, and the ad copy that we use. And the average conversion rate is 0.09%. So here's an actual campaign that we ran, a 6.28% click-through rate, a 38-cent cost per click instead of $3. And we got, you can look at 345 ad clicks. From here, they click on the ad. We got 140 of those to click on the link. And then of those, 23%. So you can see this is kind of the flow that this funnel works. They click on the ad, click on the link, fill out the form. You can see those conversions. And so I kind of broke this down for you to show you the industry average at $3.77 a click with an average click-through rate of 0.005 and an average conversion of 0.09. If you had 20 ad clicks times a 5% conversion rate, you get one click through on your website, right? And you, or landing page or lead form or whatever, times 0.09% conversion rates, it would take you 10 website clicks for one lead. So that math works out to over $700 a lead, which means most insurance marketing agencies simply aren't getting conversions, and they stay away from the insurance lead industry for that reason. They can't get a reasonable conversion rate. If you look at ours, the average cost per click at 37 cents, 6.75% conversion rate, and 39% of ad clicks converting to 23% filling out the forms, we end up with a 10 times lower cost per click, 10 times lower click-through rate, 5 times higher lead conversion rate, an average cost of $5 a lead, and 18% of those on average nationwide are converting into sales. So here's the results that our clients fill out every single week. We get this information. We want to know exactly what percentage you're quoting, how many leads you got, monthly ad budget, what your premium written was, and how satisfied you were with the lead quality. So, you know, here's just a couple of examples of some of the reporting. What you can see, you know, from a two-week campaign here, we got 93 leads, $3.42 a lead, $317 spent on this particular campaign. But I wanted to show you that this is also scalable. Here's a six-month campaign that we ran, spent $20,000, got 3,246 leads. And this individual ended up writing over $500,000 of premium over the course of 6 months with this campaign. So this isn't just a, oh, look, you got three leads, of course, you know, but what does that look like over time? These are very scalable results. These aren't just, you know, 1 month, 2 weeks at a time. We've had clients that have been with us for 4 or 5 years consistently without stopping. We are the sole lead provider for at least half of our clients are not getting leads anywhere else. They've been able to cut ad budget anywhere else that they're using because we can use a diverse strategy. We can get multiple campaigns running, targeting different areas and running different types of campaigns for you. Here's another example, 270 leads over 30 days. This is an example of a lead form that was filled out. So you can kind of see it's just somebody who's married. We know where they work. We get their address. We know whether or not they own their home, date of birth, contact information. This individual wanted auto, home, and life insurance. So it's not just an auto lead or just a home lead. It's an entire household. And you can see there's 5 cars here and even requested a callback time at 10 a.m. So, you know, you get so much of this information provided to you. And because of the targeting, like I was telling you guys, we don't just get monoline leads. We're getting households. We're getting people because of the way that we're able to put these leads in front of the right person. We're getting people who are genuinely interested and typically have much larger households than you're going to get through any other provider. So over the course of 30 days, they ended up making $8,000 of commissions, wrote $73,000 of premium, and we're spending $583.56 a month on average for the 90 days. So we profited over $6,500 of commission over the course of this campaign. Here's another one that we just ran over a 30-day period. You can see 50 to 75% contact rate. Percent they quoted was over 25%, wrote $25,000 of premium, and spent $839 on the campaign. Another testimonial, just one lead, you got 3 autos, 1 home, 1 umbrella, 5 rental properties, $10,000 of annual premium. The lead cost $4.73 and resulted in 10 grand in premiums, over $1,500 of commissions that they made. So again, these are very good quality leads with households, multiple lines, multiple cars. And we obviously know the more lines of insurance and the more items that are in that household, the less likely they are to switch again. So you're getting much higher retention rate. Results reported back to us, average monthly commission before they started with us was 10,000. Average monthly commission currently was 20,000, so $10,000 a month increase in commissions. Here was one recently from an individual that just started with us from State Farm. $135 was spent on ads that week. Got 24 quotes, conversion rates at over 25%. And resulted in $7,600 of premium written. And that was just in 1 week. So we, you know, get results like this consistently. I could show, I could literally spend an hour or 2 hours going through feedback after feedback and result after result, testimony after testimonial. But bottom line is what we do is very much a collaborative effort between ourselves and our agents. It's very customized. It's pretty labor intensive what we do, We're not just a massive aggregator like a Quote Wizard or something like that. These aren't database leads, they're not shared. Every campaign we build is customized to spec for the type of customer that you're looking for. We handle everything from start to finish. We build the ads, we manage the ads, we do daily reporting. Every morning and every afternoon, we're in our campaigns making adjustments. You'll have access in real time to see everything that we're doing, see every ad dollar, where it's spent. And we meet with you, go over all these reports, so you'll be able to know exactly what your return on investment is on every single ad. We even have calculators that show you the average value of a lead, both premium and commission value. So as we get data, we can tell you, hey, every lead that you get is worth $69 in commission when you average all of the ad spend out versus all the commission dollars generated. And when you have that kind of information, if you know, hey, a lead is worth $65 to me, and I'm only spending $4 or $5 for it, obviously it makes good business sense to double down on those efforts and stop spending money anywhere else. So we don't do contracts. We don't lock you into any long-term agreement. We want to earn your business every month that we do business with you. Our performance is the contract. I know that if I deliver what I tell you we're going to, we give you the types of leads that we tell you you're going to get, then you're going to close. And if you follow the strategies, you're going to close business, you're going to make a solid return on investment, and you're going to continue to work with us. If we don't perform, I don't expect you to continue doing business with us. I know that you won't. So it keeps us on our toes. It keeps everybody honest. It keeps you working, keeps us working, and everything works really well. We don't have openings in every state. We are pretty full right now. We try to limit to just two agents per state. Not per company, but per state. And that prevents us from market saturation. And it also gives our ad analysts an opportunity to have a wide range of targeting that they can choose from without stepping on our own toes. We don't want to cannibalize our own opportunities. You know, if we have 10 agents in one state, obviously we're pulling away from campaigns that you could potentially be using. And that's why a lot of these guys aren't able to get long-term results, is because they'll just put people on top of each other. And ultimately, if you just ran a campaign here, we can't run that campaign again for the next guy. So what we try to do is really limit that to a couple people. Obviously, there's some states that can handle more. You've got Texas, Florida, New York. These are, California. These are heavily populated areas. They might be able to do 3 or 4 agents. But outside of some of those states, we really do keep it very limited in scope in terms of who we got. We've got some states that are locked down all the way till November. So if you'd like to get some more information about our process, maybe want to see some results specifically in your area, or maybe some agents with your company, we've got dozens of people that you could talk with. We've got tons of results that we could share with you. We can log into a screen share and do a live demo and kind of show you our marketing automation and CRM tool that we use. But it's all hands off for you. We handle everything. It's a turnkey solution. And again, we just look to continue to refine our process, get you better quality leads, take the feedback that you're giving us, and actually make material changes that are going to result in higher performance for you. So if you have any questions, just reach out to us. You can call us at 888-400-9064. Or I've got Doug's contact information, just doug@surefiredigitalmedia.com. Or you can email me at seanmathistv@gmail.com. You can also call us here, 480-370-6250. That's Doug's direct number. And my direct number is 469-400-9065. So hopefully this gives you some good insight, helps you understand what we're doing, helps you understand some of the methods of the madness. Give us a call, visit us on the website too, surefiredigitalmedia.com. Go to the projects tab and you'll be able to see an actual 12-minute presentation that goes specifically into some of the campaigns that we're using, some of the ads that we show. But would love the opportunity to work for you, show you what we're able to do. Love to hear that you're firing your other lead providers, because I know that you're just wasting money with these internet lead providers. They're not getting any better. They haven't done anything different for the last 15 years. And ultimately, to get different results, you're going to really have to use a different strategy. And I believe that our strategy is the best in the business. I believe that we have the best quality leads, and I think our data will.